but it's on the last video of the week. I had to work today, unfortunately. Usually I have my Sundays off. So, my kid's godmother is doing me the honors to watch my kid. And I felt so bad imposing on her. So, I wake up this morning. Or rather, I've been awake since 4 a.m. These laxatives have been fooling me, goddammit. Usually, they take a long time, but lately, this week, these laxatives, I don't know if it's the new brand or what the hell's going on, they work really well. So, they decided just for shits and giggles to continue to work the rest of the day. So, around 4 a.m., so continued. I tried to go back to sleep around 7, and I slept for a little bit. And then my alarm, I set it wrong, and it didn't wake me up, but I was already, I have an internal clock, so I woke up. And then I woke up my kid up, and time to get the show on the road, got ready for work, and my friend got here, and got my kid, and we started to talk a little bit about this and that. She started to tell me about that she's been going to church lately ever since Easter, and she wants to go every Sunday. Matter of fact, she was supposed to go today, but she's doing me the favor to watch my kid. So she told me to tell the sweet manager, who sprung this Sunday on me all of a sudden, that no more Sundays. She can't watch my kid anymore on Sundays. She's going to start going to church. She's off for Fridays and Saturdays, but not Sundays. So I had to relay the message to him. We started to talk about this letter that I got. And the letter is, I don't know what's going on. I'm supposed to call the people tomorrow from the state and tell them that all the paperwork and things were filled out and faxed to them and find out what's going on with my license. So, but she was telling me that I can work, I can do production, I can do everything that I used to do. But that these people are just so technical and by the book that's the hold up there. So, so I get to work and I'm tired, I'm sleepy. I usually wish I had some coffee, but I didn't have time to get coffee. And I immediately go. The pharmacy is still closed and Stick in the Ass is there. Oh boy, I thought it was going to be my favorite pharmacy today. Instead it was Stick in the Ass. And already I knew it was going to be a long day because I had to work with the sweet manager and Stick in the Ass. Two combinations that don't work. Those two bicker like a married couple. And I am caught in the crossfire. So, I get there and it's just us three. This is a threesome that I don't approve of. I like three ways and all, but not that. I would say no to that three-way. So, I get there's not really much to do. The minute, there's a huge partition that closes the pharmacy, so there's already people outside. These people are like, remind me of zombies or something. They're just banging against the partition, just touching things, and they wanted so desperately to get into the pharmacy, so the partition is opened, and all these zombies just come and flood the counter. So I'm taking care of these customers. The sweet manager is not there yet. We open at 10. I have to be here till 6. I have to be from the minute the pharmacy opens to the minute it closes. Sweet manager is late as usual, and I'm trying to just get by. He comes, and he comes really flustered and just hurried, and immediately goes to punch in, and he sees me and just rattles my hair, just disrupts the do that I have going, and is like, good morning, Cindy. He calls me Cindy Lauper. So after the zombies go away, I give them their brains for the day. They go away, and I have to have a talk with him. So I tell him, listen, the babysitter, we like to call my kid's godmother the babysitter, it's like a little joke. The sitter's mad, okay? You kind of sprung this Sunday on us. He's like, no, it's your Sunday, remember? I'm like, yeah, but usually you tell me when it's my Sunday. You just don't put Sunday on me, so. I'm sorry to inform you, sweet manager, but The sitter is rescinding her invitations for Sundays, so no more Sundays. You have to schedule me for Fridays and Saturdays. I can't work Sundays anymore. So he's like, well, I guess we're gonna have to rotate, and Fridays and Saturdays it is. So, but not every Friday, Saturday. It's gonna be once out of the month, one weekend out of the month. I don't know how that's gonna swing, but we'll see what happens. So I tell him, you know, there's not really much for me to do. I can only work the registers. And then we have the question of production. I checked the QP, which is the production, and there are 4 pages. It's like so many prescriptions. It's over 200 prescriptions that have to be filled. So I tell him, listen, what are we gonna do with the production? He's like, what do you mean? You can go ahead and start pulling. I'm like, no. Did you forget I can't work production? I don't have my license yet. And then he's like, oh shit. And oh shit, because he has to now tell stick in the ass that he can't. I can't work production, and he can't work it either, because on Sundays we do a giant order. We basically run through the whole pharmacy, and whatever's missing, he has to order, and that takes a long time. He has to go prescription by prescription, fill what's needed, then he has to go pill bottle by pill bottle and just take an inventory of everything that we need and make a huge order, which takes a long time. So he tells Stick in the Ass that I can't work yet production. Stick in the Ass is surprised that I'm still, I still can't do it. And then he's just like, well, when were you gonna tell me this fun fact? You know, she can't do that, then why is she here? Talking about me like I am not in the room, you know? I hate when people do that. So he tells Stick in the Ass, he's like, well, listen, just put her on production. I mean, I can't do it. I have to do the order. What do you wanna do? Stick in the Ass just sticks his hand dramatically up in the air, and if he had papers, I think he would just throw the papers in the air if he had papers in his hand, but he didn't. And he had no choice. He had to roll over and let me do production. There was nobody else that was gonna do it. He was not gonna do it. So I got to do production today. I got to dispense medication. So I haven't done production in a while. I'm a little bit rusty. I had to kind of get back into the groove of things. And I made the suite manager try to make the effort, and he pulled some pills for me, and then I started to fill them, and I made a mistake. I didn't make a mistake. What happened was, like I told you one time, there are people that bring in 2 or 3 prescriptions, and you fill them all together, and you put them in a little basket and like that. So I filled that, but apparently they're different times. Stick in the Ass is just so weird about things, you know? He doesn't want, I don't know if he doesn't want the things touching each other. I don't know what the fuck this man wants. Apparently what I did was wrong. He didn't like the way I went about things. And so he was like, what's going on here? Da-da-da-da. And then the suite manager, God bless his big heart, was so sweet. He took a bullet for me. He's like, no, that was my mistake. And I was just so happy. Stick in the Ass only bit my head off twice today. I don't know if I told you guys, Stick in the Ass, his ringtone to the cell phone is actually a dog barking. And this man is like a dog. He just bites, you know. So yeah, he I was his chew toy twice today. And then he got tired of me and chewed on the suite manager. A far bigger, juicier toy. So I did the best I could. Today was really busy. Oh, so I was running back and forth with production, I was answering phones, I was in the front, I was in the drive-thru. And was doing every other little thing in between. So, we got through it somehow. I love the suite manager. He's cool for me. He doesn't bother me. A lot of people don't like him. He does lollygag a lot. I mean, there was a point in time where it was busy, and I thought he was gonna help me or pull pills for me or something, and this man was actually changing the garbage at one point. He just started doing random things, you know. God. So, but I did the best that I could today. That's all I could do, and I got out of it alive. My God, I'm so happy to be off. So, what else? I'm gonna chain smoke. Sorry. So, whatchamacallit. Today, not today. Yesterday, my kid lost her tooth. Which surprised me. I thought she was done with losing the tooth things, but I guess not. So she lost a tooth. No, not yesterday, the day before. I was supposed to put the thing under the pillow and do the whole tooth fairy bit, but I forgot. I wanted to make a big deal about it, you know? Because she's still so little. So there was someone who sent me, the same girl who sent me this bracelet, matter of fact. And she sent it to me in a pretty satchel. It's like a satchel that had moons and stars, and it was see-through and purple. And it was really cute. And I saved it. I saved the satchel. So what I wanted to do was I wanted to put the money in the satchel and kind of put it under her pillow. But I didn't have time to. I didn't find the satchel in time. I found the satchel this morning. So what I did was, I don't have money here. I have just money left over from the laundromat, which is just quarters, like a lot of quarters. I think I have like maybe $15 in quarters lying around. So I took the quarters to work this morning, and I got it changed for dollar bills, and I put it in the little satchel for her. But my kid went with my kid's godmother, and I didn't have time to do the whole tooth fairy bit, so I went ahead and put the money aside for later. So I got through the day, and then after work, I ended up going to a buffet. Oh boy, buffets and I are not good company. And unfortunately, I tried to kind of pay my own way at the buffet, because you know what happens at buffets. And they would not hear of this. They I was being treated to the buffet, so kitty, sorry, the cat's distracted me. My kid was with me at the buffet, and my kid has this thing. When we used to do buffets a lot, thanks to my ex, we used to do buffets every week. And I used to, well, my kid does this thing where she gets food, and then she'll get things that I like or that she wants me to try, you know? And she shares things off of her plate. So there were a lot of things that I didn't want to eat that my kid was just like, "Mommy, try this. This is so good. You have to try this." And next thing you know, things started adding up. I started to get full and full and full. I had dessert even. Oh my God. So this turned into a straight up binge. And I couldn't wait to just come home and purge really, really bad, which I did. On the way home, I got a bottle of wine. I didn't have any in the house, but I knew that I don't work till noon tomorrow, so. But I wanted to just relax and unwind, and it's been a long day, so. I got a bottle of wine, and here it is. As I was waiting in the long line, my God. I saw this magazine and I had to get it. Eating Disorder Confessions. Oh my God, who knew celebrities had eating disorders too? So yeah, this is not good for me to have. This is actually like a bad idea. But I was just compelled to get the thing, and you can just imagine. All the usual suspects are here: Angelina, Nicole Richie, Kate Bosworth. So yeah. But this is bad, bad, bad paraphernalia to have with an eating disorder. This is just thin spo for me. It's just an encouragement. I see these emaciated bodies and my eating disorders, like, you see? Now they're doing shit right. Whereas you're fucking around, and here you are, pounds, pounds later. So what are you doing? What are you gonna do about this? So but anyway, so at the buffet, I finally pull out the satchel and I give it to my kid, and she's so excited. My friend made a comment about the satchel. It was like, "Oh my God, the fucking tooth fairy is bawling." The tooth fairy. I gave my kid $3 and the little satchel, and they thought that was hysterical. So, my kid was really happy. I think she thought $3 was like a lot of money. She was like, "Mommy, I'm gonna save the money. Maybe we could do like a vacation for like a week, and we could do something really good with this." To myself, I'm like, this is just okay, honey, whatever you say. I was talking to my kid about summer vacation, My sister wants to get her for 2 weeks, so I was telling my kid, you know, when summer comes along, if you're gonna go with your auntie in Orlando and you guys are gonna have a great time. And my kid slowly started to get sadder and sadder, thinking about being away from me for 2 weeks and away from her dad and not having us there, and especially me. She was like, no, but why you can't come, come. Why you can't come? Is that such a thing? Why can't you come? She's like, why can't you come? And I had to tell her that I can't, you know, I can't get the time away. So she was just really upset. It got to the point where my kid was actually crying. She didn't want to go. She really just did not want to go anywhere without her mom and sleep in a bed without her mom and things. And so I have to break it down to my sister that my kid doesn't want to go for the summer with her. I don't know. I wish I could go. I wish I could do vacation with her, but I just can't do it right now, so I don't know how my sister's gonna take it. I had a weird fortune today. My fortune cookie. My daughter loves fortune cookies, so she's like, "What did you get?" My daughter got something. What did she get? Okay, she got her fortune said something like, "Oh my God, I have a fortune in my purse, but it's way over there." Her fortune said something about you can't walk a mile in someone's shoes. You just have to wear your own until you outgrow them or something. Something like that. And yeah, something like that. You can't walk a mile in someone's shoes. You have to just wear yours till you outgrow them or something like that. It was pretty deep for a cookie. Sometimes you get these messages. So mine says, if you tempt a squirrel with a nut, be prepared to be bitten. Yeah, I'm always being tempted with nuts in my face, so this is no surprise to me. Oh God. Jesus. When I got out of work before the buffet thing, I was talking to my boyfriend and I was telling him about stick in the ass. But I didn't call him stick in the ass, I actually called him by his name. And so I'm like, yeah, this guy had his period big time. And then Lord behold, who comes behind me? Stick in the ass. So I think he caught the period comment. That was really funny. I hope I don't work with him tomorrow. Oh my God, how awkward. He's gonna be like, bitch, I'm gonna show you what a period is like. So, hopefully he doesn't PMS on me this week. Too bad. God, what can I tell you? I got to speak to my ex today. He got my kid. And I was telling him about the school that I want my kid to go to. And I asked him if he can go tomorrow to look into that and see if she can go to that school. So I'm hoping he said yes. I'm hoping he's gonna follow through and go and not give me some excuse like you have to go with me too and all this nonsense that he does. So Jesus. What else can I tell you? Stick in the ass has a cold or something. He kept sneezing and coughing every damn where, you know? And then today I just had like the worst headache all day because I was stressed, but I had like a runny nose all day. I was sneezing, and so I think I caught whatever old people stick in the ass germs he has. So I don't know. At the buffet, I was sick too. I was like sneezing and had a runny nose, and I think I caught whatever he has. I felt like I had a stick in my own ass. You know, I was kind of just like fidgeting in my seat and stuff, and feeling mad and wanting to bitch out the sweet. I kept looking for the sweet manager in the restaurant. God. So I came home and I purged all the food, and I felt really bad afterwards, and now I'm just here. I don't think I'm gonna write. I think I'm just gonna drink till I feel sleepy and go to bed. Oh, it's a long week ahead. I have a lot of long days today, Monday and Tuesday, and then Wednesday is the lighter day and I have the weekend off. So I was gonna tell you, my boyfriend sent me a bunch of links. Sometimes he sends me links to cars and stuff that are for sale. So he sent me a link to this car that was, it was a Saturn, a 99 Saturn. I think it was a sedan, it was four doors for 900 and something dollars, like really below my price range. So I called the number and the car was sold, unfortunately. But the man who was selling the car told me that he had more cars coming in tomorrow around that price range, if that was the price that I was looking for. So I'm like, yes, of course. So I saved the number. I'm gonna give him a call tomorrow And I'm gonna try to see, maybe sometime this week if I can see the car. I don't know how I'm gonna get there. It's really far. It's in Hollywood. It's all the way, but like where my boyfriend stays, or maybe further, I think. So, I don't know how I'm gonna do that. My kid's godmother's husband actually has volunteered his services to look at the car or stuff like that. So, I'm gonna just run it by her as well. That around that Hollywood area, there are cars for sale, and I need a man to go with me and that knows about cars and look at things. Maybe, I don't know, maybe they can give me a ride and go with me and this unobtainable car and unobtainable car dream that I've been having can be obtainable, so yeah. Oh God, what else can I tell you? I don't know. Just happy to be home. Happy to be away from the pharmacy. I did not want to work today. God, it was just such a long day. I couldn't wait to just go home. Oh, and here I am. So, I don't know what else to tell you. The laxatives were still kicking at work. I went to the bathroom like three times to go. The laxatives would just not quit. It's so funny. I hope they're out of my system tonight. I can't imagine going to work and still having to go to the bathroom so many times. So yeah, jeez, I don't know. I think that's it. I'm not gonna talk anymore. I think I'm done. And I'm gonna try to vlog during the week. If not vlog, then blog. I'll try to type something. But I'm gonna be working a lot. I'm still here. I'm still alive. So don't worry about me. And that's it. I'm gonna go. I hope you're all well. And please be safe. I'm gonna try my best to behave. And I wanted to start the week differently, and here's how it started. It started with me purging. So I hope it doesn't continue that way. So that's it. I'm gonna talk to you guys real soon. Good night. Goodbye.